we've reached the final leg of the Coattail journey. Lots of learnings en route to the finish line. Digital citizenship, visual literacy, the P21 framework, the SAMR model, the TPAC integration model, literacy uses of technology, adaptive uses of technology, and finally, transforming uses of technology. Just before the India Week activities launched, the second grade team of teachers met to talk about India Week journals. During India Week, all students reflect and write in their journals daily about the various India Week activities that they have been part of. The team discussed paper journals, but were willing to explore other options too. The idea was to go paperless, with real-time sharing of the journals with a wider audience. To meet the needs of the team, using Evernote for India Week journals seemed to be the best option. Earlier in the year, first graders had used Evernote to document their learnings and observations about the life cycle of a silkworm. The first grade teachers had observed encouraging improvements in the writing process because of using real photographs versus student drawings in the journals. As the conversations continued, it was decided by the teachers to use Evernote for not just India Week journals, but for the plant journals as well.
The preparation for the online Evernote journals started with upgrading the teacher accounts to premium accounts. These were used as class accounts, and the login credentials for these were shared with the students. The students created their own notebooks within these accounts. Google calendars were used for reserving the iPads. And last but not the least, the trainings. There were trainings which were done both for teachers and IAs. These were done individually or in groups. Transforming use of technology? Was there a shift in pedagogy? Was the learning experience teacher-centered? Or was it student-centered? Did it bring any changes to the classroom management style? What was the role of the teacher?
Based on both student and teacher reflections, it was evident that the lesson fitted the redefinition stage of the SAMR model. The technology allowed to go paperless with real-time sharing with parents, which was earlier inconceivable.
Alright, so we used Evernote to do our silkworm journals in our science unit, and the kids were able to use real pictures and write real scientific observations about what they noticed about the silkworms, and then they posted that on our blog page, so their parents were able to keep up with it, and you know, they could reflect with the kids and talk about what they had learned. And the pictures were because they were real pictures, they were able to see more detail and make better observations using Evernote.
So I used Evernote to do during Indian studies. It was really a beneficial thing for the kids. Number one, normally we would print out all the pictures and every activity they would do. But during Evernote, we had the kids bring their iPads, we took pictures, and then we went to the Dropbox and they could pick which picture they wanted. And from there, they were able to write their journal. So we did not waste a lot of paper by printing massive amounts of colored pictures. They were actually picking their own with their activities they had done and writing about it. It was an excellent transformational thing. I got more information from the kids and less paper waste.
Banyan and People both had their separate accounts. Every student got their own journal, which then we did notes on. And every activity in Ninja Week, we would put a photo and write about it. And a lot of our main activities in when we were studying plants, we took photos of them and uploaded them onto Evernote.
Now let's analyze the journaling project through the lens of the TPAC model and see how the pieces fit together. Within the TPAC framework, there are three primary forms of knowledge, the first one being content. We have the content for the India Week and the plant units documented using the Understanding by Design template in Atlas. The enduring understandings, the essential questions, the knowledge content, and skills for the unit are already in place. As per Punya Mishra and Matt Kohler, they say that pedagogy is the teacher's understanding of how students learn, general classroom management skills, lesson planning, and student assessment. Just recently, we were at a TPAC planning meeting, and the second grade team of teachers had some great insights into building the inquiry process, which is a pedagogical approach for the science units. The team of teachers said, quote unquote, "Our current science unit has a lot of activities but not as much authentic inquiry. Maybe we let go of some of those activities to help kids have some ownership around forming a question they are really interested in knowing more about." The Sketch app was used to label the parts of the flower. Sketch notes sync directly with the Evernote plant journals. For the Evernote plant journals, one of the second grade groups used the Think Puzzle Explore routine. This is a making thinking visible routine which helps to build inquiry with the whole group. A teacher-created note with guiding questions was pushed out to the students' plant notebooks in Evernote. The students then worked independently on the iPads to record their reflections and thinking. Using Evernote enabled the controlled release of the inquiry. And lastly, the third component of the TPAC framework, that is technology. In this case, Evernote service was used. The structure and nature of this tool helped with adding another dimension to the process. It helped build for independence for both teachers and students and make deeper connections with content and pedagogy.